Welcome, Hamish. So I was going to make it a joke about illuminating, but I decided we've had enough of those today.
My goodness, for a change.
What are you going to light us up with?
Okay, so we're going to talk about pendant lighting, and the Team Lighting Plus have got a huge range of pendant lights, and we're going to talk a little bit about how you choose them and what their applications can be.
Okay, so what do we need to consider when we're choosing a feature light?
Well, I think the first thing you sort of want to get into is what you want the light to do. So if they're going to be pendant lights, say, above a kitchen, you know, you're going to want them for task lighting, or if they're going to be above a dining room table, you're probably just going to be hitting more for some ambience in the room. So really think about how that's going to go. So the first one we're going to have a look at is the Newham pendant. It's a very good example of having control over your light source for a specific space. This modern interpretation of a chandelier is perfect for halls and stairways, as you can rotate each arm and then direct it where you want it. So I mean, it's a modern take. We've seen them. I like them. They're Ooh. Nice and simple. And yeah, there
that's
you go.
Cool.
That is cool.
That's cool. That is cool.
Okay, so can you give us an example of some more task lighting?
Okay, yeah, so we've got the Miele light, which we're going to have a look at now, and this is an integrated LED bulb. Okay, these are perfect for over an island bench, and you can make an amazing feature with them by clustering them at a few different heights.
Well, that's nice.
Yeah, and again, another great innovation with these pendants now is the consideration when it comes to the ceiling canopies. Not the ceiling rose, the ceiling canopy.
What's that?
Right. We're going to have a look right now. Okay, it's the piece that actually fixes it up to the ceiling, so you can see how now they're actually more styled and they're more in keeping with the design of the light fitting.
That's
so it becomes more like a piece of art as opposed to it looking merely like an attachment to the ceiling.
It used to just kind of be that thing up there.
It was just the thing up there. Now we're trying a little bit better.
Nice.
That's really, really nice. So what other options have you got for like a kitchen island? I'm in the market for something.
Kitchen island. Right, for you, Mel, I have the Eaton range. Okay, so these are perfect, and they're going to fill whatever size of space you have.
Oh.
We like those. I particularly like them. They're kind of that sort of iron sort of finish. They're a cool modern feature, and they've got a knuckle joint between the rod and the ceiling canopy. What's cool here is you've seen rake ceilings in the past. They're often really hard to light, where in this case, you've got a knuckle joint, so you've got a rake ceiling in your kitchen. The light swings down and hangs level for you.
What's the knuckle joint? Sorry, just explain.
So knuckle joint at the ceiling, so it swings that way when it's fixed. So if it's on an angle on a rake ceiling, it'll swing down level so the light itself will hold the level.
Got it, thank you very much.
So thinking about size and space, is it a consideration?
Hey, yes it is.
Always, Brayden.
Yeah, it can be a catch. I've walked in before and of course seen people with ginormous light fittings in very small spaces and also been remarkably underwhelmed by the dining room pendant. Smaller in a stairwell. Okay, so something you can have a look here is the mirror. A great range. These are a great example of considered simplicity in design. They have LED strip lights and both send light up and down so it bounces off the ceiling. The best part is they come in two sizes, so this is perfect for getting some balance in your room. So you can have the larger mirror, and that's if you've got a higher stud height, you can have that, because then it's going to give you that sort of sense of it floating. But it doesn't really matter if you've got a smaller stud height, you can actually get the smaller variant of it. So once again, we're thinking about scale in the space.
They're really striking.
We also have the halo rings. I quite like the halo rings. They're probably one of my sort of favorite things. They're nice and simple, and you know, you can adjust them to whatever height you want. Now the key here is when you are doing this, be there with your electrician, because the standard question that one asks is, what height would you like your light at? And this can be affected by how high the people in your home are, or how you want it positioned over your dining room table. Love it when they're like, wha-chang, up to the ceiling, or they're so low on the table that I'm going, hi, Brayden, hi, Mel, while we have our meal.
That is super cool, though. I realise it's so modern and just different. So what if you don't have much space? Can you still have a feature light?
You can. Okay, so we've talked in the past about, you know, close to ceiling light fittings. Yeah. We've run through those. And the two that we have, which are the two I prefer, you know, that I've seen. Okay, we have the Sputnik first. Obviously named after the small, you know,
space
Russian thingy. See, you know, my history's sensational, isn't it? And then we have the Orleans, which sort of is heading more down that Moroccan sort of thing.
Really cool. I like that one.
I like that one too, you know, with its sort of faceted glass frowns around it. So there are options basically for everyone.
Okay, bring it on home. What have you got for us last?
Okay, lastly, we have the Camden and the Sherwood. Mm-hmm. Okay, these are pendant ranges. They come in plenty of different sizes and feature mixed materials, which is on trend at the moment. So again, depending on the space you wish to light, you can go for either a smaller one or you can go for a larger one. Another advancement that they've come through with, you've either got an option of now hanging them with a chain hanging system, or you've got the direct rod to the ceiling. You see the difference, what we're talking about on screen there?
Oh, yep.
Okay, so you can mix them up. You can effectively do whatever it is you want. You can have a stylish light from the light to the ceiling.
I have a question about that.
Yes.
A bit left field. I have a house which has got quite a lot of wood in it. It's darker than that. Would you stay away from mixing woods, or is that okay?
I don't mind mixing different timber varieties. I mean, we do it all the time with our floors, through to our kitchens, through to our furniture. Yeah. So I think it's okay. It's more about having a semblance of continuity within the timbers, perhaps, but changing the colours and adding things in is fine by me.
So yes, you can.
Thank you.
Well, Hamish,
I feel better.
That was a long-winded yes.
Hey, thank you, Hamish. Those are really cool lights. I really liked a lot of those. Really good to have you in the studio. As always, now, if you're inspired, head in store to Lighting Plus or online to make the most of the Best Buy sale, where there's 30 to 60% off store-wide.